Thank you. Thank you. fair if I do the same. And there, something that I think is maybe great for all of you to know is that I still get nervous too. I'm pretty sure Ms. Romine's here is also nervous, and let me tell you the reason why. And that is, even though we are the teachers here, and you know we're kind of supposed to be something like experts or something, all of you and students too, at this point you all have a pretty good idea of if it sounded right. And we know that you know. So students, this is your turn to get to watch us sweat it out. I hope it goes well. Secondly, I would like to introduce a very good friend and colleague to you all. Mr. J. Romines is someone who's been very, very kind to me since I arrived in Knoxville, I'm not gonna say how many years ago. But he's just, I mean, he's a super fine colleague, he's a fantastic musician, and he's just one of the kindest people that I've ever met. So without further ado, Mr. J. Romines. Checking in with his instrument, I think I'll say a little bit about this duet. This duet is written by German Baroque composer Georges Philippe Telemann. Telemann lived at the same time period as Bach. So we're talking about before the United States was a country. Telemann is, I feel, just a distinctly intelligent composer. And he wrote this series of duets, a total of 6 sonatas, that are written in canon. And what that means, if you can think of the song Fair Jaca, where you know someone else can start the song halfway through it, and then the two songs as they're being sung at the same time from different points work out to be something nice to hear. So what Telemann was able to do was write an entire piece where he's gonna play the exact same thing that I play, one measure behind me. Sometimes I just marvel at the mathematical skill that Telemann must have had in order to write this. This is his second canonic sonata. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.